Okay, it's time to talk about AI in DeFi Render. That DeFi Render is ahead of the curve, we know. It's become quite clear that they're constantly looking to implement more and more features, especially AI, and they listen to the community for feedback. In this video, I want to go over the tools and features powered by artificial intelligence in DeFi. As of right now, it's the engine that is implementing the most AI stuff in the market so far. What we have is a set of tools that allow us to get better results faster and solve specific needs. So first, to add to this conversation, I don't think the process of rendering a 3D space is going to be replaced completely by AI anytime soon. AI still, and probably will be for the next few years, an extra tool that we can use. I might be wrong, but for now, it allows us to get to realism much quicker. I have this project here from Vaga Arquitetura, where I got to visualize these facade images. And I also created this interior scene here to use as an example while I'll go through all of the AI features worth checking out in DeFi. Now, I'm super happy to say that this video is sponsored by DeFi. DeFi Render is one of the tools that I've been using for a while as my daily render engine. So I'm honored to have them supporting my work here and allowing me to create more videos for you guys. Okay, let's quickly go over the steps here so that we can get to the more important stuff. This is not so much of a beginner tutorial, but to cover the basics, you get your 3D model in your preferred 3D modeling software. In this case here, I'm using SketchUp. And then you install the sync or live sync plugin that DeFi offers, and they offer for many different 3D modelers. And this is definitely one of my favorite features. Being able to quickly go from designing and modeling to visualizing is super important for an architectural workflow. Then you do the typical work here, right? Start working on materials, either using something from the ready-to-use library or creating custom materials by hand with all of the necessary maps. Then set up the scenes, add the assets, vegetation, people, surroundings, and so on, which, by the way, is also something that is one of the strengths of DeFi, this huge ready-to-use library that includes models, materials, particles, scatter, HDRI, and recently terrain. The free version gives you access to a limited offer, but the pro has it all. And I'm showing you all of this here in just a few seconds, but this whole process to get the model to this place here, render and finalize the images, took me only a workday, like everything, which is super fast. Okay, now let's talk about the AI features, and I'll start with my favorite and the most powerful one DeFi has, the AI Enhancer. Then at the end of the video, I'll show you a more advanced technique on how to fully take control of AI enhancements on architectural visualization. So be sure to stick to the end of the video. Once you have your model ready to render, you go here to image, and then you set up the preset size. Make sure to enable the channels, and this is just good practice so that you can work later in Photoshop if needed. You don't need to mess up with the aspect ratio here because that is done better over the scene settings. And then you hit render. And while we briefly wait here, not for too long, because from experience, all it ever takes is just a few minutes to render an image. And this is a 6K resolution. Then once it's done, you will get this pop-up here with the AI post-processing option. And by the way, every time you see this symbol, it means that it's some sort of artificial intelligence capability. When you click on it, it will take you to the AI post-processing window, which you can also get to here. You can pick from multiple sources. All you need is to do a render first. And a huge improvement that we got from the last update is that now it is possible to use this up to 6K resolution, a bump from the 4K limitation we used to have. On the right, here it is, AI Enhancer. This really changed the game for me with DeFi. So let me quickly go over the settings here. It's pretty simple. Here, you're able to pick and choose the parts of the image you want enhanced. This is definitely a cool feature, but from experience, I feel that it doesn't give you that much control. It blocks some of the parts in different ways. I mean, not ideal in my opinion. This is why I prefer to have the enhancer go over everything and then use Photoshop to filter this part, which again, I'll show you at the end of the video. For the enhancement weight, I'd recommend doing some testings. I've always used the default number so that it's not too strong to the point that it generates some unwanted artifacts, but feel free to test it out. This little button here is only if you're using the masking. Then you can set different values for different areas. Feel free to use it, but you'll see that with Photoshop, we have this with much more control. Then all you have to do is click on the AI Enhancer Purple button, Simple as that. This feature is still in beta, but this last update made this tool already much faster. It used to take hours to enhance an image, now it's done in a matter of minutes. And once it's done, the preview might not show just yet, but I found out that if you go to task, then you can see that it's done, and from here you can download the image. Which, by the way, it is an image file, an AI-enhanced version of your base render that looks more realistic. And what I think makes this AI enhancer that is built into D5 super useful is that it's made for architectural visualization purposes. It adds an extra layer of realism, especially with more dirt and texture to the nooks and crannies of the image. It helps to make it look more real with deformations and imperfections. This is something that we would have to make manually and would take hours and way more computer power to accomplish with other rendering engines, and sort of how we used to work in the past, right? But now that can be added quickly to the base renders. There are also a bunch of other AI enhancers out there if you Google for it, but I feel that often they do more damage than good to your images. After all, we still want to show the project, the design, and not lose the details. And if that's the case also with the AI enhancer in D5, then again, we can use Photoshop for that. The second on this list of AI features that D5 has is also here on the AI post-processing. It's the AI style transfer, which is also a fantastic addition. It's the same workflow from the AI enhancer, so you need to render an image first. Then you click here to open this AI style transfer tab and pick either from stylized or realistic. There are extra settings here to fine-tune the process, but I'm gonna go with the default settings for now. Feel free to play with this, this is quite intuitive, but let me show you the examples with this project I have. On stylized, there's watercolor, cartoon, pen sketch, pencil sketch, marker drawing, scale model, and voxel. Then on realistic, there's sunset, night, spring, autumn, and winter, and even a style transfer from reference. As you can see, they are interesting, but they can produce some unnatural or unwanted artifacts on the image, on your building. Overall, you don't have the same level of control as if you were actually drawing with, say, a marker or doing a night scene. I mean, from a day scene like this one here, it took me around 30 minutes to convert to a reliable night scene. And that's what I'm saying here. Depending on the stage of the design process, if you have your design already advanced and detailed, it might be better to put in the time. I feel that this AI style transfer is more of an experimentation feature, but I'm super glad it's available here because it shows the commitment of D5 to getting exposure to new technology. But again, more than the AI enhancer, this AI style transfer loses the details of the projects in some parts, like the facade materials, plant species, and so on. So be careful when using it. By the way, this entrance with this vegetation area was done using individual plant assets from the asset library. But also a key thing here is the scatter grass, which is definitely my favorite tool of D5. I made a whole video about it when it came out. I think it really is the most powerful thing in D5. And to give you two extra tips here on top of that video I've created, I like to add sometimes multiple scatters to create the grass. So the main one where we'll have the actual grass, and then, for example, an extra one on top that will have maybe just dandelions or different grass weeds with the mask, so they show only on certain parts of the grass area. All this to create more complexity on the grass while still allowing the main one to be full and dense. And then tip number two, I find that the grass objects here in D5 sometimes are too large, so making them smaller tends to give me more natural and fuller results. But this is all about testing. There's so much control here on the D5 scatter tool. Okay, next up on the AI tools, we have a few dedicated to materials, which is such a vital part of an architectural visualization workflow. It makes so much sense to implement this type of technology in this part of the process. And there are three things here that D5 is working on. On every material, we have this little setting here, the AI generated texture maps. If you don't know anything about materials in Archviz, for it to look realistic, it requires maps that will tell the engine what type of surface this is. Like normals for the bumps, scratches, details, and so on of the surface. Specular or reflection for the shininess or reflectivity of the surface. Roughness to tell how glossy or matte it will be, and so on and so forth. There are multiple maps that can make up a material. But I know that sometimes you need to use a certain texture. Either came from a material supplier or you took a photo on a site visit, or it's the specific texture you found online and you don't have the maps. There's a whole manual process of going about and creating them, but here you can just click on generate and it takes care for you in just a few seconds. It doesn't compare to materials you see on the asset library, for example, or the ones that you paid for, but it's much better than not having it. So I really like this feature for some specific textures I need to use. And on the same necessity, sometimes you need to make the texture seamless or higher resolution. So within the base color map here, which is your diffuse or albedo if you're coming from other rendering engines, you have these options here. Again, this little icon for AI stuff. All of this is small, I know, but D5 Focus is about using AI to give us more control of the process. It's using this technology in a practical way to solve one small pain at a time, which gets me super excited for future updates to come. Now, moving on to the next AI feature, the AI Atmosphere Match, which allows you to upload a reference image and let D5 AI help you set up the render settings to make it look like a reference. So it changes the lighting, weather, LUTs, and the settings. But I can't just point this out by itself, as I feel it's not a setting for yet type of tool, but as a way to test out and get started with the settings. So this leads me to the D5 Studio, which is not AI, but it's a complement to the AI Atmosphere Match. It's a library that gives you templates, or maybe better said, a compilation of settings to help you quickly see your project in different moods and styles. My personal recommendation is that if you want to use it, that this is a super cool feature, but always tweak it further. A set of settings that worked for this image here, for example, on the thumbnail, will not fit perfectly for you. So you might need to twist the sun, play with the exposure a little bit, and so on. Okay, now moving on to a more experimental section of the AI tools in D5, we've got the text to 3D, which is located right here. And then it opens this window where you can create 3D objects. Mostly decoration stuff for now, to be honest, based on prompts. I see the potential, and again, it's better to have it and see how it will get enhanced in the future, but as of right now, it's very experimental. It's quicker and more reliable to just use stuff from the asset library in D5, but I can't wait to have more options with this text to 3D tool. I really see the potential in here. Now, lastly, on the AI tools in D5, for now, I can really see that this video is gonna get outdated pretty quickly once D5 moves into newer versions. But for now, there's an even more experimental tool that is not available to everyone yet called D5 High, where we'll be able to also render based on inputs of words or images. Again, very experimental feature, but once it fully comes out, it's gonna be amazing for the early stages of visualization. There are other places that you can do this sort of render, but I believe that's something built into the engine that you will use to then do the final renders and further develop a scene once it has more details makes much more sense. I don't like using the term AI loosely just because it's cool and trendy, but I actually want to see the practical uses beyond just the hype, and that's what I think D5 is looking to do. So a quick recap. AI Enhancer, to add realism with textures and detail improvements. It's a standard workflow at this point. Amazing tool inside D5. AI Style Transfer, a cool way to test different styles and results, but that can alter a lot of your project, so use it with caution. AI Generated Texture Maps, a super handy tool to help you use specific textures and turn it into a PBR material. Ultra HD Texture, upscale smaller textures into higher resolution. Make Seamless, a quick way to get rid of seams on textures that are not ready for 3D yet. AI Atmosphere Match, a fantastic way to get started with your scene settings and rapidly change moods, but remember to tweak it further then. Text to 3D, a tool with huge potential that is now mainly used for decoration and simple objects, but I believe we'll get a mega update in the future. And D5 High, render with words or image inputs, ideal for early stages of visualization. Now, as I promised, I'm gonna show you how to fully take control over an AI enhancer in Photoshop. And by the way, this is something I also teach over the D5 Render Visualizing Architecture course, which is my full course on D5 and Photoshop, where I teach you everything you need to know to create amazing renderings. I'm a D5 certified instructor, so if you're looking to learn D5 render in full, be sure to check the link in the video description. Also, if you want to start using D5 render today for free, you can. D5 has a free version called Community, which is a free forever version. There are a few small limitations, like the limited assets in the asset library or the fact that the AI features are not included. But that's it. You can render high quality images and videos with the community version without any sort of watermark or reduced quality. I highly recommend just trying out for yourself. Just go to d5render.com to download it for free. And when you're ready to upgrade to a pro license, I have an affiliate link that gets you a discount. And by using the link, you're also supporting us here at Upstairs. First link in the video description. Okay, so let's get to Photoshop. So you have your base render here in Photoshop, and I recommend always bringing in the render channels here to assist with the process. Then I import the AI enhanced version on top of the base, and I like to combine these two into a folder. Then with the AI enhancer on top, create an inverter mask. You can alt-click on the mask button to do that. We want a black mask that hides everything. And now it's a matter of coming here with a white brush, just painting in the areas you want to review. This way you can really choose how much of the enhanced image you want to review. And what's even better here is that you can use a brush with a lower opacity to have an even finer control here. So sort of choosing the intensity of the enhancer that's going to be revealed. Not to mention that using the material ID channel, for example, you can select by materials and review based on a precise selection. This is the maximum level of control, and I recommend doing this every time you work with AI enhanced images. This one here didn't alter the original design too much, but it happens, and you can sometimes lose details and building elements if you just skip 100% of the AI enhanced image. So be careful with this. And this is not a D5 issue, but all AI enhancers out there do this. But I feel that D5 does a better job of making sure that it looks natural and usable with a focus on architecture, as I mentioned. I have the images in full detail on my Behance. All the links are in the video description. You can also check out Vaga Arquitetura website to know more about the project. Subscribe to the channel if you like this type of content and want to see more of this. Be sure to leave a like if you enjoyed it. It really helps the video. And thanks a lot, D5 Render, for supporting Upstairs and making this video possible. I'm looking to make a more in-depth tutorial in the future on D5. So if you have any requests on specific workflows or questions in general, feel free to drop them in the comments below. I'll see you in the next video.